Welcome to StatsKingdom.com. Today, I'll show you how to use the calculator for chi-squared tests. Go to Sample Size, select Test Power, and click on the chi-square test power. Choose the relevant test, which is either goodness of fit or test for variance. Choose the significance level. The significance level is commonly set to 0.05, and choose the sample size, which is the number of observations. Next, define the effect size that the test needs to identify. You will need a bigger sample size to identify a smaller effect. If you are not sure which effect size to choose, you can use the effect drop-down menu and select small for a 0.1 effect, medium for an effect size of 0.3, or large for an effect size of 0.5. If you are still not sure, choose the medium effect option. Next, choose the number of categories. Now press the calculate button. In this case, the test power is approximately 0.117. This means that the probability to reject an incorrect null assumption is 0.117. This value is too small, and we usually want a test power of at least 0.8. The null hypothesis assumes that the statistic follows a chi-squared distribution with 9 degrees of freedom, while the alternative hypothesis assumes that the statistic follows a non-central chi-square distribution with 9 degrees of freedom and non-centrality parameter of 1.8. The critical value is 16.9. The gray-blue plot is the H0 distribution, where the blue part is the significance level. The red-green plot is the H1 distribution. And here the red part is the beta, while the green part is the power. If we choose a large effect size, the H1 distribution will move further from the H0 distribution. In this case, to the right, and the test power will be larger. Let's try this. Additionally, you can generate the R code for this calculation. Press the How to Do It in R link, and then copy the code to calculate the same results in R. Then paste it in R Studio or an online R emulator. If you're using R Online, you should ignore the first line of package installation. And running this, we obtain the same result. Now let's go back and move to the next test type, test for variance. As you can see, the fields have been adjusted for the test for variance test. For this test, we have more than one option for the tail and different effect size definitions. The effect size is defined as the ratio between the variance that a test should discover and the null variance. For example, if the null variance is 8 and the ratio is 1.1, as we have got here, then the test should identify a variance that is larger than 1.1 times 8, or 8.8, or smaller than 8 divided by 1.1, or 7.27, or one of them, depending on the tail type. Now pressing calculate, we see that the test power is approximately 0.096, which is too small. If we want to identify the sample size that will meet the required test power, we can go to the chi-square sample size calculator.